Hi everyone, and welcome. This lab that I'm gonna do now is to actually configure DHCP in the router. This is a request from one of my subscribers. They wanted to know how to do that because the Inter-Vlan lab that I posted, I don't know how long ago, maybe a couple days ago, a week ago, I don't remember. Okay, it was really DHCP that I did on the server. They wanted to know how to do DHCP on the router. So I'm gonna do this lab. It's specifically a request, but I guess everybody's gonna benefit from it. And I like that. I don't mind that, okay? I wanna get all your feedback. I mean, it's great, but if there's something that you wanna see, let me know, okay? And I'll whip up a lab and I'll put it out there, okay? All right, now we have three switches, or not three, four, we have a core switch, and we have three individual switches. This will be, I forgot if I put a VLAN on here or not. Oh, here it is. This is VLAN 30, so I did this quickly. This is VLAN, this is VLAN 100. Yeah, that's what it is. VLAN 100, this is VLAN 120, and this is VLAN 130, all right? In the video, it shows you how to create and assign the VLANs. So let's go ahead and take a look at that real quick, all right? This is the sales VLAN, and we're gonna do show VLAN. Let's just maximize it, not play around. Okay, there's a 130 VLAN sales and exactive on the first 15 ports, all right? Lovely. Let's go to this one right here, the middle one, just to verify that it's done already, all right? Okay, enable, show VLAN. Okay, and you can see there, VLAN 120, that's accounting, active on the same ports. So minimize that. Okay. Enable, show VLAN. And then we have VLAN 100, HR, active on the same port. Now remember what I said about VLANs, all right? Any VLANs other than VLAN 1, the ports must be trunked. So this core switch is where I trunk the ports. Enable, show, int trunk. Okay, and you can see that ports 21, 22, and 23 are trunk, which are the ports going to each individual switch. Once you turn on those trunks, it puts the 802.1Q protocol, okay, which is the encapsulation type that you're gonna use on the router. They have to match, all right? But there's one port that's not showing up there, which is port 24. Okay, now port 24 is this one, as you can see right here. And the reason it's not showing up because that router's interface is off. It's not configured. And we're gonna go ahead and configure. So I'll put in the IP addresses for each particular, and you know there's gonna be, well, our computers are gonna be set obviously to DHCP because I'm gonna be doing DHCP on the router. But remember, for each subnet, I always use the first available IP address for the PC, and then the last available IP address for the router, okay? Which is 100.254 or whatever subnet. This would be 100.254 for that router, 120.254, and then 130.254, okay? All right, so let's go ahead and go to the router. As you can see, we started in setup mode. Oh, here we go. Where's the router? Right here. Come on, line up there. Ah, okay. All right, as you can see, we're in setup mode. We're gonna say obviously, nope. We don't wanna go ahead and use the wizard. We're gonna do enable, config T, just name the router just for naming, just to name it. Host name, host name R1. All right, let's first put in the IPs for each particular segment, all right? So you're gonna go into the interface, F0/0, and then we're gonna go IP. No. That's the physical interface. We're gonna say no shut. It's the physical interface, remember, there's a router on a stick. So you have three different gateways, you only have one physical interface. So we're gonna do everything in sub-interface. So let's go up, so we're gonna do this fairly quickly. The first VLAN is 100. So sub-interface 100. Then we're gonna do the NCAP 100. Oh no, NCAP 0.1Q. .1Q space 100. Okay, and now the IP address. IP address 192.168.100.254. Then we're going to put 255.255.255.0, the mask. Right? There's no need to turn on or do a no shut in the actual sub interface. It's the physical interface that needs to be on. So let's up arrow. And the next sub interface we're going to create is 120. Then we do the end cap. I'm just doing up arrow just to make it quicker. All right, 120. Remember, the encapsulation is the one that needs to match. All right. And then the IP address, which is 120.254. And enter. Then the last one is 130. And then 130.254. Oops, passed it. Okay, Control Z, WR, which you can't do in your cert. All right, show IP in brief. Take a look at the summary. And we see everything is up. And we have the 100 with the 100, the 120, the 120, 130, 130. Let's verify indeed that that was it, 100, 120, and 130. So we're okay. Now it comes time to actually configure DHCP on the router. Okay, let's maximize that. So just like with any DHCP, we need to create a pool of addresses. All right, and remember, you can question mark your way through all this stuff. It's not a big deal. Okay, if we question mark here, IP, then you see DHCP right there. So DHCP, and you go pool. You can put excluded addresses. I don't have any exclusions right now. Just showing you a basic configuration. So the first pool we're going to create, it's going to be the HR pool, okay? Now you're in DHCP configuration mode, right? And what are you going to do there? There you're going to set up your range, I guess, if you want to call it. All right, if you question mark, you're going to put in the default router. We have no DNS and the network. And you can also put on options. But again, we're not going to do that. All right, what we're going to do is simple. Default router, because we've got to give the IP address of that particular gateway, all right? So for the HR VLAN is the 100. So that's 192.168.100.254. Okay? And let me see. Yeah, that's it. All right? And then we put the network for that particular HR. So we go IP, network, 192.168.100.0, 255.255.255.0. Oops. Network 192.168.100.0 255.255.255.0. Okay, and now we go out one because we need to create another pool, right? So we got the first one, which is the HR pool. The next pool is the accounting pool, which is the 120 VLAN. All right, so we're gonna go IP DH tab. Oh, come on, DHCP tab or pool. Okay, and the pool is gonna be ACCT, accounting. All right, now what is it going to put? The default router. The default router is going to be 192.168.120.254. Okay, that's the gateway address. That's what they're talking about. All right, and then we're going to go ahead and put the network. Network, 192.168.120.0, 255.255.255.0. Zero. Okay? And then exit one time, create the other pool, IP, DHCP pool. And then the last one was sales. And that's the 130. So we're going to do, what is it? Default router. And that's 130.192.168.130.254. And then the network is going to be 192.168.130.255.255.255.0. Let's do it the right way, like you would in the certification. Exit, copy, run, start. Do a show start. And there you go. You got your three pools. okay, right there. The first pool for HR, 100.0 network, that's the mask. That's the router, the gateway. That's what you're talking about, the gateway. IP, DHCP pool, the accounting, the network, the gateway, sales, the network, the gateway. All right, okay. Now it's gonna know, it's got a range. If you don't put that default router, it wouldn't have worked. All right, because it needs to know the gateway. We could add exclusions, but we're not going to, so it's gonna choose whatever within that range. It has the network, and it has the address of the router, therefore it can acquire it from the router. So let's see. Let's go here. There you go. Let's put a static so you know it is receiving one. All right. From the DHCP, they got the first available. All right. Remember, I have no exclusion, so it's going to pick the first one available, which is one, and then you see the gateway of the router. All right. Let's go ahead and go here to the middle one. All right. Let's go ahead and go back to static, back to DHCP, and 120.1, and then the last one. How to do that? Okay. So you see that the right IPs are being assigned to the right VLANs. How is that? Because my God, it is extremely hot today. Excuse me. Okay. Maybe I'm drinking too much protein. I don't know. All right. How is that assigning? How does it know what IP address to assign to each particular VLAN? Well, remember, in each sub-interface, you have the IP address for that particular gateway, and you told it that for the first VLAN is the 100.254. So when the request, right, the discover, it gets it, it knows where to filter from, because already in that packet, it's going to be a destination from that network. So it knows already that it's coming from that interface, that sub-interface, that's in the 100 or the 120 or 130. So that's how it knows which one to assign to each interface based on the IP addresses that you have already assigned to each sub-interface on the router, all right? So it's simple. It really is. It's a very basic setup, but essentially, that's it. You create a pool, you tell it what network is on that pool, and then your default router, which is your gateway address. You want to do options? You can do options for DNS or whatever, is it, or whatever else you want, right? And then you have exclusions. If you want to actually create a range, you can exclude out, let's say, I don't know, first 20 addresses, and then it would be 21. It would start from that one. All right? So that's a basic DHCP. It's not a big deal, okay? One final note, you know, I hope, again, just watch the video, whatever, but one final note. First, thank you for all the feedback, and please, I welcome your questions. I've been trying to be better and answering them as quick as I can, all right? I'm going to try to continue to improve on that. But now remember the website, all right? The website, or we already have the courses up there that I've created. You can purchase it right from the website, okay? So don't forget that. You can go to thenetworkingdoctors.com, or you can go to udemy.com, or all the other pages that are there. If you go to the website, it'll tell you where you can go, okay? But definitely, you can go to the website and start purchasing the courses already, okay? I think there's four up there that we've been able to place up there, okay? So now we're really moving along, okay? And of course, you always have the option to go to Udemy, all right? If you don't wanna go there, you wanna go to Udemy, I mean, it's your option. You can go wherever you wanna go, okay? So again, it's up to you, all right? But there's just a little lab in response to a subscriber. And please, if you have a doubt, if you have a question, and you wanna see a lab, all right, that's geared. Remember, right now I'm giving everything to the CCNA. Soon, I'll be putting courses out there for the CCNP as well, all right? I'll separate the three different certifications, all right? And I was just told, okay, that I keep forgetting because my brain's all over the place, we will also be doing Microsoft, okay? I don't know exactly when, but hopefully before the year is out, I'll be putting up there Microsoft classes as well. So there's a lot of new things that are coming up. I am also bringing on board instructors that have worked with me, okay? They're just like me in the sense that very dynamic and they don't play games and they don't try to make things complicated. I'm gonna tell you straight up what it is, all right? But just keep on the lookout. So we're gonna have all these things. They're gonna be available here on YouTube, on the website itself if you wanna purchase the course with the DVD and all that, and of course, udemy.com. All right? All right, guys, I hope you liked it. I'll see you again.